Hi, it's Connecticut personal injury attorney Ryan McKeen, and I'm here with Connecticut medical malpractice attorney Betsy Ingraham. Good afternoon, Betsy.
Hi, Ryan. How are you?
I'm doing well.
Good.
Betsy, today we're here to talk about medical malpractice cases and really three reasons why somebody may have been the victim of medical malpractice, but they have no case, which seems really unfair to me.
It is. Medical malpractice cases are really hard to bring. It's not as simple as a car accident case. Somebody hits you, you have an injury, you can bring a car accident case. The courts in the state of Connecticut have set up sort of a hurdle that all people who file a medical malpractice case have to get over. And that hurdle is you have to have what's called a good faith certificate accompanying your lawsuit. And a good faith certificate is a piece of paper from a doctor that they have reviewed your medical records and they agree that what your doctor did was negligent. And if you don't have that certificate, you can't file a medical malpractice lawsuit in Connecticut.
So what would happen if you tried to file one and you didn't have it?
If you didn't have the certificate, the case would get thrown out of court and you would lose your opportunity to sue that doctor potentially for good.
And it's my understanding that this is a very complicated certificate because, you know, you have to have the exact credentials of the person who committed the malpractice. Can you talk a little bit about that?
Sure. The doctor that signs the certificate that would go along with the lawsuit has to be the exact same type of doctor that committed the malpractice. So, for example, if it was a brain surgeon who committed the malpractice, you would have to have another brain surgeon review the medical records and say, yes, this was negligent.
So it might not be good enough to have like a neurologist review.
No, it has to be the exact same specialty.
And is that true even if it's like a nurse or a dentist?
Yes, a nurse or a dentist is the same thing. You have to have someone in that specialty. So, for example, if the nurse is the person that committed the malpractice, it's not good enough to have, say, your primary care physician review the records. It has to be someone who has the exact training and certifications of the person that you claim was negligent.
Now, can those people be really difficult to find?
They really can. So oftentimes you have to go outside of the state of Connecticut because doctors are not willing to look at the claims against their fellow colleagues. So you have to go outside the state and try to find a doctor who's willing to get involved. It's also very expensive. So you have to hire the doctor who charges sometimes hundreds or even thousands of dollars an hour for his or her time.
Yeah, and I mean, I think thank you for clarifying this because I think for people out there, there's a perception that it's like really easy to sue doctors. And at least in Connecticut, we've had tort reform that really made it very difficult to bring claims against doctors exactly for this certificate of good faith. And, you know, this may be the subject of another video that we'll do, but I mean, just briefly, I think it's important for anybody watching this, if you think you've been the victim of medical negligence, to contact an experienced malpractice attorney quickly, because it can take a long period of time to find and get that certificate of faith correct. And if the attorney doesn't have the time and it's too close to a 2-year statute of limitations, that you might not be able to file a case because simply the attorney does not have the time to do it.
Right. It takes time for the doctor to review the records, to write up the good faith certificate, and for the attorneys to file the case in court. So you only have 2 years from the date of the negligence to get that done. So it's important to contact your malpractice attorney as soon as you think there might be a problem.
And so Betsy, if anybody has a question about medical malpractice in Connecticut or good faith certificates, what's the best way for them to get a hold of you?
You can call me at 860-471-8333 or email me at Betsy, B-E-T-S-Y, at cttrialfirm.com.
Thank you, Betsy.